few years ago, I was on a field visit in Kanha, which is in central India, and I was interviewing this auxiliary nurse midwife, a young woman, and I remember, you know, through all my questions, I asked her, what is the most challenging part of your job? And with a deadpan expression, she said, the animals. And I was so surprised, I stopped. So she proceeded to tell me this story about how she was up early in the morning on her way to one of her villages in the catchment area, which is in the periphery of the jungle corridor. She was a few months pregnant with her second child. Her first child was with her, was about 1.5, 2 years of age on her hip. And on the other hand, she had this heavy bag with all her healthcare paraphernalia. And she came upon a sloth bear. Now at this moment, she was terrified, but she couldn't say anything. She couldn't walk away. She couldn't even change her body language because any sudden movements from her would agitate her child, which in turn would agitate the bear. So she stood there, stock still, for 15 to 20 minutes till the bear walked away. And then she proceeded on to the village and completed her work for the day. Now this is one of my favorite stories and experiences from my field work because it's one of a million such stories and experiences of the women who work in healthcare in India. Every government program in India is finally implemented at the grassroots level, mainly by women. We have close to 2.5 lakh auxiliary nurse midwives, women, 1 million accredited social health activists, women, approximately 1.5 million Anganwadi workers, women. So you're looking at this country with all its diversity, with all its vastness, with all its challenges, and is managing the health care of its population through women. And I feel so privileged to be part of a project like eVIN, or the Electronic Vaccine Intelligence Network, that is now empowering this health force through technology. It's empowering them, and it's also changing the dialogue. It's changing this belief we have that smartphone technology or an application is something that is so challenging to people from a particular background or a particular gender, particular age group, when in fact the acceptance of eVIN, the adoption of eVIN by the same health workforce through the application has allowed the country to visualize close to 650 million doses of vaccine in real time and optimize their vaccine supply chain. Further, I feel really privileged to be part of a generation that is actively working towards women in a leadership role in health, in technology, and in science. And I'm not going to say it's not tough or it's not challenging, but it's worth it because it's women empowering women, it's women mentoring women, it's women helping women. And